it's Friday.
Are you okay?
I felt that sneeze come on in the intro, and I was hoping to hopes that it wouldn't go off when I hit unmute on the mic, but there we go.
Well, there it goes. You went off at just the right time. Hi, everybody, and a good to you, too. It's Friday. We've got mascots. Those are the problem. Luckily, we've got the solution, which is you. You get to decide what we do with these mascots. Do we propel them into stardom, or do we send them down to an early grave?
I'm going to sneeze.
You're going to sneeze all over them. Yeah. They're going to have to put in a sneeze guard at the mascot buffet.
That's disgusting. Hi, everybody.
I can think of no better start to a stream than that. All right, so it's 3D platformer time. We're playing PS1 platformers, and as usual, your job is to tell us whether these games are better or worse than GEC 64. So keep that in mind as we display these games, show off the best parts, the worst parts, and decision is yours.
The decision is yours. Real quick, I want to thank some folks. Thank you, Shine and Era, for the 25-month resub. 25 months. Thank you.
Thank you for 25.
1,000 bits from the Ultimo. Thank you very much. And Seraphis Kane with 100 bits in Exontide. Appreciate it. Seraphis Kane with the 31 months, and Gazontide. Sepicide 19 with the 100 bits in the Gazontide. Everyone's blessing me. I appreciate it.
Bless you. Bless
and thank you.
Thank you,
Jamie VX, for the 21-month resub. Do appreciate that.
Bless you and bless everybody.
Bless us all.
Let's play some mascots. We showed like 2 minutes of gameplay before the show, and instantly everyone was just like, this game isn't real. You just programmed this and made this up right now. Mm-mm. Nope, this is a game I've been wanting to stream for a long, long time. It's almost happened. Like, I'm pretty sure we had two different streams where this was scheduled, and then like we had to cancel at the very last minute for various reasons.
Yeah.
Something's keeping us from streaming Rascal.
Rascal's cursed.
Whatever curse we're keeping the lid on, it's going to get unleashed when we play Rascal in a few minutes here. So get down to your bunker. And prepare for the worst.
Gaming bunker. Thank you, Nocturne Dustclaw, for gifting a sub to Bobinator. Welcome to the sub club, and welcome to the world of Rascal.
Rascal?
Rascal.
Let's do it. We're playing Rascal. No holding back now.
Are you sure? Can I hold back?
The apocalypse has officially started.
No. Is that why I sneezed? Was it like a sign?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I don't even know if I got in a word before you did the sneeze, dude.
I know,
I think I just said, it's Friday.
You said it's Friday, and then I just went, duh. All right, this guy.
Psygnosis and Traveler's Tales present Rascal for PS1.
Is this the controller?
This is the controller.
Oh, okay. I'm grabbing for the wrong controller here.
Yeah, remember, you have to play this. As usual, Alex is here to give his everyman's opinion of these video games. And I'm here to give the contrasting opinion of a video gaming expert. And yeah, Jim Henson's Creature Shop was involved in this, the London branch. They only make English Muppets.
The English Muppets are the ones with nooks and crannies, right?
Yeah. Now, I'd never seen this CG intro before loading this game up, and man, this is really something. I just wasn't prepared for how Rascal was rendered in this intro.
Oh, wow. I'm going to say it. I said it before the stream. I'll say it now. That's Drill Jr. Look at him.
Who's that one kid who was annoying on PBS? Caillou or something?
Caillou? Are you saying it's grown-up Caillou?
Yeah.
Okay.
Caillou's going apeshit.
People hate Caillou.
Not many people have opinions on Rascal, but those who do have very strong negative opinions.
Is Caillou Quebecois? I'd start international controversy with the...
No one wants to claim that guy. Belongs to the sea. So what's going on here? Well, there was a scientist guy. Rascal busted in. Now he's running from these little freaks. Man, if only there was a Rascal director's cut. Can this game be fixed is the question. It has a spooky game over screen?
We'll have to see that. Multiple people talk about the game over screen, so that's good. comments from Reverend Crush letting us know he looks like the main character of Treasure Master.
He kind of does. I hope he has that strut. Thank you.
I cannot believe Caillou is Quebecois. How is this how I find out? Why do I always find out the most amazing themes on things on stream?
Secrets revealed on Retro Pals Mascot Friday.
That's why you gotta watch. Yeah, this is all Jim Henson, baby.
There's so many good faces.
Yep. That's how I look.
Mm-hmm. And so our quest begins. Rascal.
Rascal, okay.
Also known in Japan as Bubble Gun Kid. Just a little Rascal trivia for you there. Made by the team at Traveler's Tales, who made stuff like Sonic 3D Blast, as well as Lego Star Wars. I guess this is their first 3D platformer in the style of Lego Star Wars, so... Man, from humble beginnings. That's a good title screen. Oh, man.
I don't know what any of this means, so I'm going back.
It's of that era where everything is pictorially depicted, so they didn't have to pay for multiple languages. And instantly, the game just drops you in.
Oh, no. No. Is there an error? Is this really?
Alex, you cannot use the analog stick.
No, this is, shut up.
This is a 3D platformer where you have to use the D-pad, and it uses boosted tank controls. Inspired by the boost train. Thank you, everybody, for the boost train.
For the boost.
If you got recommended this stream, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, you have to watch Rascal now. But thank you for watching, if you're watching.
So, when I tested this out earlier, can you tell me what the strange things about the controls are?
They're bad.
Yeah, there is that.
Square issue. That's kind of weird.
This was just before DualShock, yes. This was around the same era as Bubsy 3D.
Oh, yeah.
So... Do you notice how when you push left or right, you go forward? Or wait, how are you doing that?
Up goes forward and back goes backwards.
Okay, what if you push left or right on the D-pad?
You just turn.
You just turn?
Yeah.
Wow. I was playing it earlier and he was like going forward always when I pushed left or right. That was kind of annoying.
Is this one of those games where I'm good at it because it's for psychos?
Yeah, it could be.
Okay. I'm jumping on the bed. Look at this. Look at this bed.
Visually, it doesn't look bad. These are nicely rendered environments. In which a small child is wandering.
No, what does the pipe do? What is it? Is it like, is it a sewage pipe?
Yeah.
Is it for like when you shit your bed?
Yeah, this is the UK, Alex.
Okay, I'm sorry. I don't know how they shit the bed in the UK.
They do it different over there.
Okay.
They have pipes in place.
Where does this go? Oh, hold on. Hold on.
I have heard that too, that this game was supposed to have more quote unquote normal controls, but then at the last minute, they were forced to fuck it up. Okay. I really wonder what the good controls version of Rascal would be like. Maybe we'll see it someday. And also, I didn't figure a way out of this this hub world, so good luck, Alex.
I will. I bet you 100 bits I can do it.
You think they were inspired by Ninpin Monmaru? That yes. may have been the case.
Okay, forward.
And... I'm sure it's a fun game with good controls. I'm sure of it. We just have to verify it for our list, you see.
Can this take me somewhere?
Have you found the secret to getting to level 1?
Have I?
I wish I knew the answer. The game just kind of plops you down into places.
There's a door.
Yeah, this was 1998. So they had to have known about Super Mario 64 during development. They maybe weren't as blindsided as the poor Bubsy 3D developers were. This is a story that's often told, but if you haven't heard it, the Bubsy 3D creators saw Mario 64 for the first time at CES, where they were also showing off their game. And their legit response was, oh shit. Yeah, 98, this would be competing with Half-Life. You can see all the, what do you call it? What's the fancy word that gamers use for in-game cutscenes? Stages? Stage plays?
Stage plays?
Interstitials?
I found some balls.
Not cinematics, not diegetic. Funny with my voice? Okay, there you go. Machinima. God damn it. Is gonna kill me. Set pieces. God damn it.
They call them set pieces?
They call them set pieces.
They do? What the fuck?
Yeah.
Don't call it that.
or gaslighting me.
Yeah,
set pieces didn't exist until Half-Life, and this game has set pieces. Ludonarrative disassociation, that's also true. I feel pretty disassociated right now.
Run! God, you little bastard!
That's cool how when you back up into a wall, the camera just goes up. So you can't see your character or the thing you're running from.
Jim Henson Workshop, huh? From the makers of Fraggle Rock comes Fraggle Rock.
Wow. I was gonna go with Fuckle Rock.
That's good. Much better than mine.
I guess you can consider this an action platformer, given you have an unlimited attack when grounded. So maybe there's less of a focus on platforming and more on action in this game. But is that a good thing?
The controls are made worse by the camera, yeah.
Yeah, the camera keeps swinging around whenever you do anything. How would you describe the controls so far?
I hate being, like, just bad, but...
You could shoot rats with a bubble gun.
I mean, I can do that in a lot of things.
You could do that in real life.
Yeah. Did I just go back? Ball sack. Oh god, spider! I found one of those today.
You're no angry video game nerd, Alex. Keep your day job.
Okay, fair enough. Let me in!
I have noticed a lot of square-shaped rooms so far. It seems like they've got a default shape for the environments. Occasionally there's little hallways like this, but I guess this is more in the vein of something like, weirdly enough, Resident Evil, in that the rooms are distinctly separated and there's load points in between them. Speaking of toy guns, I bought my first Nerf gun the other day.
You did?
It was $4 on Amazon.
Nice.
Suggested price of $30, so I think they were clearing them out because either no one wanted them or they were defective or something.
I'm being pushed by a rat.
It was a Fortnite-branded Nerf gun.
Cool, very cool.
And upon loading and shooting my first dart, I realized there was no way I could ever use this in front of other people or animals because it's fucking loud and it shoots things out at a billion miles an hour. Like, I was expecting a shitty little gun that could maybe knock over a DVD case, but this thing, it would knock you out if it hit you in the head. And it makes a loud as fuck noise. The first time I shot it, the cat just jumped out from her hiding place in the closet and ran out of the room.
Oh no, poor Tessie! Did you get it for the cats?
I was kind of hoping to play with the cats, but yeah. No, it makes such a loud noise and it's so violent. So keep Nerf guns off of this year's Christmas list unless you want violent kids.
Got it.
Yeah, as a kid, I thought Nerf guns were supposed to be shitty. I was like, okay,
yeah.
I don't have a Nerf gun. I bet that would be kind of fun for like $4. No, this is a deadly weapon in the right hands.
So is this like one of those things where it's like, man, this used to be way different when I was a kid, but like actually?
Yeah, they're like military grade now. Yeah, they need to get nerfed. Nerf this.
I think I'm going backwards.
Well, this is a good sign already. Not really knowing which direction is the way forward. So you're just kind of wandering. It doesn't help that the camera is pointed directly at your character upon entering a room. It doesn't really establish a direction to go.
Rat! Yeah, I wonder... I'm with you. I bet Super Soakers are, like, pressure washers.
Oh, God.
Now.
They're like fucking fire hoses. Watch out. Who knew that one of the toys to not get cheap and shitty over the years is Nerf guns? Where the technology has only improved and become more deadly over time. Do you enjoy the act of shooting spiders and putting them into bubbles?
I'm kind of getting sick of that, but let's go back.
You could think of this as a Halloween-themed game. It's pretty spooky.
It is pretty spooky. You're right.
It's got the rats and bats. If this was Sega CD Dracula, you'd just be kicking that shit.
Okay, it's just different. Oh, I got that blue key. Cool. Let's go back.
Oh, man, there's keys?
Yeah.
Fuck this.
I got killed by a rat. We are not doing that with any Nerf guns.
You don't need to modify it for it to be deadly. I already feel bad about having this in my home. What if the cats get a hold of it?
God, don't teach the cats how to use guns. Actually, I think the cats would be fine, but if the neighbor's cat learned how to use a gun, we'd be...
Oh my god, we'd be fucked.
Have we talked about the neighbor's cat who's insane?
The neighbor's cat is insanely friendly, or rather, insanely playful and insanely aggressive. Those
are
the two words
I use. Yeah, aggressively playful, like... We had some...
More playful than aggressive, but also very aggressive.
They love to pounce on people who are coming up to the door, so...
And also they prowl around after midnight, so if you go out to take out the trash...
They pounce you, right?
They pounce the back of your leg midnight.
They also like to come up to the windows and slap them
mm-hmm.
to piss off the cats.
This looks like something I wouldn't want to do with these controls.
Oh yeah, it sucks.
This fucking Dr. Hauser shit. Yeah, we live next door to Tom and Jerry. That's the thing. They're very loud.
He's always like, yell, or whatever that Tom yell is.
This is like Sin's Fortress. You're going to be fighting some lizard men in a second. You're going to get up to the top and have a boulder dropped on top of you. That's exactly how my Dark Souls playthrough ended in Sin's Fortress. I spent so long getting up to the top, I was thinking, man, if I don't do this in one shot, I'm never going to come back to this game. And after like an hour, I finally got to the top, and something dropped a boulder on my head, and I died instantly. And I put the game down, and I never picked it up again. Fun, though.
I caught this guy in
it. I don't know if Dark Souls is any better than this. We'll have to rank that one later on.
I don't know what I'm doing. This isn't doing anything.
You're making him very bubbly. If you keep that up, his armor might rust.
Yeah. Something's happened. There we go.
That worked? Okay. Thank you, Spartanberry.
Thank you, Spartanberry.
For the 41 months. I should have protected the cats from Rascal, it's true. They're not in the room right now, so don't worry about it. These environments just remind me of something like Alone in the Dark 2. It's just all dreary and dungeon-like. Why are you in a dungeon? You're a kid with a bubble gun.
Why am I not in a dungeon? I'm a kid with a bubble gun.
So far, I have not seen any platforming, but I'm sure there is platforming. This game is categorized as a 3D platformer.
There is jumping, so I gotta get on something.
It's a little bit of Kingsfield Jr., yeah. I'm getting that impression.
Die! Die, sir! Die! Thank you.
See, your strategy is sound. You see a guy coming towards you, you want to back up. But then the camera is just like, oh, I can't, I don't know what to do with this. That's so good. The soundtrack sucks ass.
Oh, do you not like it? Is this where I just was?
I think so, yeah. Okay. Written by Danny Elfman's fail son. Sorry to Danny Elfman's actual fail son.
I was gonna say, Danny Elfman's fail son's probably really nice.
Yeah. Can we get him on the show?
I wanna show this.
Sorry I called you a fail son.
Okay.
Is there a map? Can you hit select or start or something? Aha! Good map! That's a really good map. Did you draw that, Alex? You did a good job.
I am so sorry, Willie Trump.
Oh my god, you had this kid? Holy shit.
I'm so fucking sorry.
Now we know for sure that at least one kid played this back when it was
We're
new.
We're sorry.
It's so... This game is bizarre.
God, please, no. Please. Sir.
You know, the game doesn't like the backup strat, but it seems to work.
It's just...
Oh, you played it on Bleem? What a way to play it.
Oh my god. Go.
Of course, nowadays, you kids use Duck Station and your cheats to make this game seem playable and fun. No one does that.
Oh, this sucks. Danny, it's a platformer.
Oh,
for real.
Here you go. It's a platformer. It's official. Thank you, Crush Gals, for the 27 months. Your backup strat. How do you double backup? I think that's just forward.
Carefully.
What a great time to introduce platforming.
This sucks ass.
did the Wrath of Cortex soundtrack. You know that's weird, because in the demo there was like a tropical level, and they was playing, it was playing some music that sounded like it was exactly from Crash Bandicoot, with the bongos and everything. Yeah, not even Duck Station can fix this. All the ducks working at their maximum capacity cannot fix Rascal for PS1.
No, you...
I could see the lighting.
You stupid...
Can you really not get out of there? That's so good. It's just a death trap. Oh, you did it.
Barely. This game is for evil.
Now, people have noted this does have some pretty impressive lighting for when this came out. The frame rate, pretty stable. It looks, at least most of the time, to be 60 FPS to me. But, the big problem here is how it controls.
Like shit.
Yeah. These environments are very small. They should be easy to navigate, and yet... What the fuck?
She's dead. Don't worry about it.
Alright. Yeah, I think their big point of inspiration behind changing the controls... this game had executive meddling, famously. Tomb Raider had come out, and they were like, oh no, this has got a control like Tomb Raider. That's the new big thing. Rachel Retro, thank you for the 57
Rachel,
months.
Thank you. Free me, Rachel. Help
it does
me.
Look smooth, but it suffers for it. You gotta have an equal amount of smoothness as well as good gameplay. And here they put all their stat points into smoothness. You got graphics. You got a talented team. You got Jim Henson's London group. I'm sure they're just as good as
Why?
The U.S. group.
Oh!
You have a butt stomp! Of course you do!
I was hoping for a freaking double jump, but...
Nah.
No, I need a double jump. How am I supposed to get here? How am I... Do I need more rice?
Yeah, look! It's like you're... It's like you're on top of a giant block of, dry ramen. What are those supposed to be? Maggots?
I think it's rice. I think it's grain. I think you're in a granary.
The rice is huge, though. It's bigger than his head. Oh, the Muppet Show was filmed in the UK. Is that true? Wow. Mm-hmm. All right.
Yeah, it's technically British. All right, I'm not. How does that make you feel?
I'm not going to lay the blame on the Muppets then. Their hands are clean.
Oh. Apparently, I just need to go this way, and I was making a big mess for myself. That's fine. Okay, gotta go up. No, God.
Watch out for the ghost pictures.
It's fine.
Did the UK appreciate the Muppet Show more than Americans did? God damn it, America. You didn't realize what you had.
Pretty sure was Rock and Rock also filmed in the UK? I know one of those shows was filmed in the UK. I know,
The Fraggles were American. The Doozers they had to import from the UK.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
It does have that weird blurry look to it. Maybe this is supposed to look better at 50 FPS.
So here's the thing. Your bubble gun sucks ass, but yeah. Jumping is good. What the?
Whoa.
Excuse me.
Layering issues. Is that for real?
Yeah.
Cool.
I was trying to see if I could jump on top of it to go up here, but apparently not. Okay, I'm gonna go this way again.
Oh yeah, y'all do use Muppet as an insult over there. That's incredible.
Wow.
I can't imagine that kind of world. Where you'd get mad at someone on the street and say, "You Muppet!" That's real life in some parts of the world.
That's amazing. That's incredible. This game sucks.
Is this a dead end?
Yeah, but it shouldn't be. See?
Wanna check your map? This game was made by fucking Muppets. It fits.
This
oh, they made it more
to me.
They made it more confusing. What's with the dotted lines? Good. Is there an exit in the upper left corner of the room there?
Yeah, but I can't get up there. See? There it is. Right there.
Yeah.
Okay, I have to go in through another door. Okay, that's fine. Whatever. Moving on.
The UK Fraggle Rock had a different human in it.
Yes, it did. Fraggle Rock actually localized with different humans.
Interesting.
For different countries. Yeah.
I guess you could just swap that out because the two segments of the show are very different.
Mm-hmm.
That's the energy of Sam the Eagle thinking he knows what the kids are into. This is Sam the Eagle's game, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Very workmanlike, very straightforward.
Stop!
The question is, will we finish level one?
No. I don't think we're gonna get far. You know what? I think once I die, it's gonna be your turn to play, and you must suffer.
Okay, yeah, you're on your last life, so... Oh, boy.
I didn't do that on purpose!
Are you sure? Are you sure you didn't do that on purpose?
Well.
Cool. Let him go. Let him go. He deserves this.
All right, it's Danny's turn.
Wow, that's... I can see why that would scare kids. All right, it's bad and nightmarish. So you would have had a bad time, and even after you went to sleep, you would continue having a bad time.
Hey, everybody. Welcome. I don't have to play anymore, so I'm happy.
All right, it's time for Danny, the gaming expert, to offer their take on Rascal for PS1.
I hate him. I know I said that earlier, but I really, truly do not like him.
No, like, what am I doing wrong? I'm holding right now. This is what he does.
Are you pressing right or right forward?
Wait a minute.
The diagonals move you forward, and yeah.
I see what it is. Do you see what it is?
It's moving on the diagonals, but it turns on the what?
I actually wasn't holding the diagonals.
Oh, okay.
I was very confused. It turns out, if you're moving while you push left or right, you continue to move, but you also turn when you do it. So I'm pushing right, and now I'm pushing left. I'm not pushing up at all. I'm pushing left now and pushing right. However, when I come to a complete stop, he pivots. However, he takes very long to return to his starting position. He skids a lot.
Yeah, it is boat control, not tank control.
So once he starts going and you hit left or right, you better hope you're still going. It may be helpful to just use up left and up right by default, because I just kind of expect it. What's this?
It's bubbles.
Are there any other cool moves like the butt stomp that I should know about?
No, not that I was able to find. I found the butt stomp, I found the shoot, and that's it.
Okay. Let's go back to the game.
Is this game for British children? That's not fair.
You know, British children's entertainment is really twisted, but I don't think it's the children's fault. like Games Master?
Yeah.
There would be a show about video games, and there'd just be a bunch of jokes about jerking off.
Mm-hmm.
Or Count Duckula, where it'd be a children's show, but there was jokes about jerking off. What was with all the jokes about jerking off, you guys?
Were there jokes about jerking off in Count Duckula? I haven't watched Count Duckula in a billion years.
I can only assume because I saw there was a ZX Spectrum game based on it, and the title of it is Count Duckula in No Sax Please, We're Egyptian. Literally the title. What does that fucking mean? Other than to just be an incredibly awkward sex joke.
That is an incredibly awkward sex joke.
And it has been a long time since I've seen Count Duckula.
Yeah, okay. I remember Count Duckula being a major disappointment in that it was just kind of boring, but it had a really cool theme song. And I guess I'm not the only one who felt that way. I'm not the only one who is a Count Duckula contrarian.
Yeah, let's put him in prison.
Wait, I don't want to put... Well, I mean, what has Count Duckula done for me?
Nothing.
It's true.
Danger Mouse has done more for you. Cool balls.
I think Banana Man has done the most for me.
What about the bananas in pajamas?
We're not on speaking terms anymore.
Say what you will, they got drip. I think this game has ruined my brain.
You can't just say whatever you want on Twitch.
It's Mascot Friday. That means I get to say what I want.
Thank you, Nelson, for the 18-month resub. I don't even know what's going on in the stream anymore.
It's so hard to keep track, because every time you enter a room, the camera pans over you.
Yeah.
And then by the time you gotten all the enemies off of you because they instantly swarm you, you're like, where was I facing? Where do I go next? I'm pretty sure this is the next door. That's why having a map would be good, but it just makes things more confusing.
Yeah, the map doesn't work.
God, when you try to get away, the camera just zooms in on Rascal. Am I hitting something? All right, I can get rid of the UI. Cool.
Ultra Pancake, I'm thinking about animated fruit, like, you know, fruits and vegetables and stuff, and whether or not those count as furry, and I want to say it doesn't. Because furry, because, you know, everything's like animal, vegetable, and mineral, right? So I feel like you're either horny for animal, vegetable, or mineral. And VeggieTales would be like, yeah, that's vegetable. And mineral would be like, I don't know, the trolls, you know.
You can't
just
bring up horniness and VeggieTales within the same breath.
I didn't mean it that way. You know what I mean. Like, yeah, Attack of the Killer Tomatoes did have a furry tomato. You're right.
Those are the most sexless vegetables I ever seen.
They're very. And I don't mean anything. I don't care about those vegetables or whatever. I'm talking about, you know, like the vegetables from Epcot or, you know, the vegetables from I don't know of any other adult themed vegetable thing. Sausage party!
I think you've talked yourself into a corner.
I have.
Alex.
I don't like this corner.
I don't like this corner.
This corner sucks ass. I'm sorry.
It's the worst corner I've ever seen. Oh my god. No, don't make me do this.
Oh, this is bad.
This sucks.
I'm glad I didn't have to do this because I would get sick.
Oh no. Oh man. That's cool. That's cool that they would put something like that in the game so soon.
Yeah, you know, troll dolls have the gemstones in their stomachs, so I assume they count as minerals.
Yeah. Can't argue with logic.
You can argue with logic. Don't even try. Is there literally nothing down here? Oh, wait, no,
there's a thing over here. This really lives up to expectations because it's just so painful to control. And you don't really know where you're going, and your brain is screaming at you to play anything else.
Okay, you're right. Transformers and robots also count as minerals.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, let's keep breaking them up. What else fits into various categories?
Well,
Transformers are minerals, but are GoBots.
Yeah, they're both made out of metal, which is a mineral, which is made out of minerals.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
No, I've been here before. Let's go.
This
let's
sucks.
It's cool. Sucks. That's so cool. Did they really think people wanted to play this in this state? Well, the developers didn't, given that they had to retrofit a terrible control scheme that they didn't believe into the game, but I'm just wondering if this is possible to enjoy. In any aspect. It's no Blues Brothers 2000. That game just makes you...
Oh, no. I'm getting pretty big Blues Brothers 2000 vibes.
It's not bad enough where it makes you sad that you're alive.
Okay,
okay. Wow.
This game is good now.
He's bad. He's evil.
No, he's great looking, so he's fine.
No, stop, Rascal. You have to stop in place. Oh, Rascal. Oh, this ain't gonna be good. He keeps going! I just want to turn and face my dragon. Do I have to put on the brakes by pushing down? I think that worked.
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to put on the brakes before you turn. So. God.
GoBots have fleshy brains? Anyways, 200 bits from Reverend Crush. Googly, googly dragon. I love him. He's a good guy.
That's a nice dragon.
L1 may also help you stop quickly, from what I see.
Let's see about that.
It does!
Look at that, it does!
Thank you, Space Dumpsters, 39-month resub. That is an extremely high-quality dragon. It is!
He's a good one. Okay, that L1 trick actually works a lot. Otherwise, you just end up skidding everywhere.
Was
why did all right
did,
How do I go to where you were? That looked like the more fun zone.
Well, you have to go back, and then you have to open up the yellow door with your key, and then you have to open up the blue door with your key. Luckily, you've got both the yellow and the blue keys.
Okay, so I just went here for no reason.
Yep.
It's not Blues Brothers 2000.
You keep telling yourself that, I think just to pump yourself up so you're not despondent.
I'm trying to think of what else is in the bottom five. Once you get to this game, this kind of quality, you're all like, man, do I want to play video games at all? I just want to go to sleep instead?
Yeah, no, actually, I'm with you. I do feel very tired, and it's hard to describe. This game is tiring.
It's draining.
Yeah. Honey,
it's only level one. Yeah, I went back because that whole area went nowhere.
This sucks.
I did kill the Blombie Dragon.
That's good.
Now I'm looking for the path that you took earlier.
I think this is...
Okay.
I'm so lost.
How about arrows? How about voiceovers that say, hey, dude, go over here?
Yeah, like anything, please, Jim Henson.
Yo, this room over here looks tight. We should go there. Things like that.
Yeah.
No, I
went. You're back. Yeah, that's the yellow door.
Okay, so where's the blue door?
Turn around. Go through that. Yeah, it's not through the yellow door. I was wrong. It's the blue door is just ahead, though.
I thought the blue door was past the yellow door.
I thought so, too. I was wrong.
That explains a lot. Yeah, look at that. The yellow door is just a trick.
This is an Amiga. This does have Amiga game vibes.
I'm so glad he has brakes. Oh, this is when you hold the brakes and run. Eat. Help.
You're good, you're good.
It happens every time. Yeah, I'm missing Elmo right now.
Mm-hmm.
If only Elmo was here.
Wait, Traveler's Tale's first game is just called Leander?
Mm-hmm.
Danny!
They brought it to Genesis as a Galahad, which we played recently.
Leander's a city!
Yeah.
You can take the train to Leander!
Mm-hmm. Leander's a much better game than this, by the way. All right, that's a poison cannon.
Oh, I refuse to rank every Lego game.
That's a tall order. You know, they just released a Lego Star Wars based on the newest trilogy.
They did?
Yeah, like 3 years after the Rise of Skywalker came out, and everyone loved it universally.
Oh yeah, especially the Lightning Planet. They have a lightning planet that you can't look at.
For a while, they just had it was just a game based on The Force Awakens, and they didn't bother making one on Last Jedi, so I thought they were done with it. But then they were like, nope, here's a trilogy based on the hit movies everyone loves.
Everyone did love them.
Luckily, there are sound effects, so I can determine when the enemies die, but otherwise it's pretty hard.
Yeah. It's all 9 movies? Okay. I just want to see the part where they go to the lightning planet and I have to look away because it makes me nauseous. I don't know, and I don't want to rank a Lego platformer is the problem.
Yeah, they're all kind of samey. You get like an okay time out of them, but eventually they wear out their welcome. Eventually there's some dumb puzzle that takes you too long to beat and you're like, I should be better at this. This game is for children.
And then your co-op partner dies and you lose bits. And
yeah.
You get really
and then you don't get the bonus at the end of the level, even though it's C-3PO with wheels on him or something.
It's something that really doesn't matter.
Yeah, I've played a Lego game before. Believe you me. Oh, boy. Don't. Look, I don't use brakes when I play racing games. I'm not gonna use brakes in a freaking platformer. What do the gun pickups do?
They make your gun more powerful.
Okay.
Oh. Kill him. Get his ass.
I got
him. Close to that door.
It's a struggle. This one's a struggle, folks.
Okay, you're officially somewhere I haven't been. I see that door up there. I bet that's how you get to that second level you need to go to.
We found the officer's quarters.
Yeah. Alright.
How do they sleep when the beds are burning? Oh no, those are just like torches.
Yeah.
Is that treasure chest?
I think you have to jump on the treasure chest to get up the bed.
I see.
There you go. Hell yeah.
Wow. That blue.
Alright.
Okay, I have to very carefully step across this. That's so dramatic.
Beautiful.
He's a rascal, alright. I just don't want him to veer off because he's gonna go on the first floor and then I have to repeat all this work.
Slow. Don't shoot me, I'm nice.
I shot the heart.
Y'all like that music?
I hate this music worse than anything.
You don't have the red key!
Oh my god.
Can we switch games? It's about time. It's almost like...
It was pointing me towards this the whole time, and I... Well, it's just as well. No, 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 no. We have to keep going. This is what the people wanted to see after so many years. Rascal.
Yeah, but... We have, like, 4 games to get through.
Yeah, we don't have to play all 4. We could cut Barbie.
Are you saying... That I had to, I had to suffer through Rascal, and I don't even get Barbie.
You just get more time to enjoy with Rascal. Let's find that red key. Alex is livid. He spent months.
No, Chad is livid.
He spent months trying to book Barbie on the show.
Did you hear? They need a Barbie photographer at the Museum of Play.
They do?
Yeah, they need someone who's just going to photograph Barbies for a year. God, I wish I had talent. I'd do that.
Sounds like a sweet deal.
I know. I want to photograph Barbies. I'm a gay man. I can photograph Barbies.
Yeah. You were here. This
yes,
is where
I
you
was
were.
Here. You're going the right way here, yes.
Okay. Let's hope we find that red key.
You shouldn't ban me because I'm cool.
You gotta learn to do this move whenever you enter a room. You like wiggle the camera back and forth to see what dangers await you, except in cases like that where it gets you killed. So that's good. I like that it sent me all the way back. I think that's the best part. Alright, don't go in there. That's for later.
For that guy.
Hey, cool dude, I think we should wait and come back here laters, is what he should have said.
He should have. They should have given you at least some hints instead of no hints.
Why doesn't he speak?
They spent all their money on Muppet technology, so they couldn't afford it.
Maybe they're just trying to silence him for his controversial opinions.
Yeah.
Okay, we're back at the big maggot room.
I wish you didn't call it that.
Well, I calls him like I sees him.
I mean, you're not wrong. Yeah, they couldn't make Rascal today in today's woke culture.
Yeah, exactly.
They'd be like, turn your baseball cap around, soldier.
Oh, Yeah, okay, so this is the place where we were before.
Yeah.
Just on the top floor. I don't see a key in here. You know what? I think the popular opinion is right. This game sucks ass.
Sucks ass.
This is one of the worst things I've ever played. I'm not sure
there
having...
There was a switch in the bunk bedroom that we missed?
What? Hang on. I'm going back there. How do they expect you to find anything? Nothing stands out whatsoever.
This game's worse than Bubsy 3D.
Wow. You know, you're right. We did finish
Bubsy
a few...
Bubsy will yell at you, didn't tell you where to go, at least.
We did beat a few levels of Bubsy 3D. That game is, by that definition, more playable than Rascal. Now, where was the bunk bedroom? Was it,
go that way, then turn.
Was that the mistaken room I went into?
Yeah, go. No, no,
fucking...
God!
No! God damn it. Okay.
Okay, turn around. Yeah. There you go. That's where it is. Just
no, it's still alive.
Ow! Okay, there's a bunk bedroom. Everyone's like, there's a switch in here, so let's find
that
switch.
Okay, let's find it.
Okay, not here. We'll find it.
This is amazing.
Is that the red key? No, it's something red, though. Okay, Chad, I'm looking here, and I don't see a switch on the wall. I think y'all imagined it.
We'll never know for sure.
Up on the wall, right next to the last bed.
All right, let's see about that. Getting up here is a real challenge.
I see it. Okay. See it? It's on the left. It looks like a regular piece of decoration.
Are you shitting me?
Yeah. Oh my god. Thank you, chat. I'm sorry I said that wasn't real. I bet that did it.
So what did that do?
You're gonna find out.
Oh, look. This moves now. The camera's not even working like it's supposed to. It's different now. Is this just a blind jump to the left in 3D space? This is cool. Whew.
Okay.
No, see? I'm glad we played this far. We wouldn't have known this was part of the game if not for the helpful chat who somehow knew that there was a switch in that part.
I'm dying.
I can't believe they're doing this. What's... Is this a blind jump? Doesn't seem to be a first-person view, so,
This is a silo room, yeah, see?
Yeah, we're in the silo room. I'm making a blind jump. There's nothing there.
Okay. Oh! Okay. That just makes you able to go down here. That sucks. This sucks.
He's gonna get eaten to death by rats.
Thank you.
Is the fate he deserves. I was planning to keep on playing while we rank this, but I don't think he deserves even that.
Yeah, are we actually not going to play during ranking?
I don't think we're going to play during ranking. You keep this on in the background so people can see it. Oh, let's see the game over again. Good. That's me looking at Rascal being chewed to death by rats. All right. This is the part of the show where you get to tell us what you think about what you just saw. Folks, based on our ranking scale, is Rascal better or worse than Gex 64? You can let us know with an RP Gex cool or an RP Gex nerd, depending on how you feel about it. Rascal, what'll it be? Is it better or worse than Gex 64?
Bottom five, worse.
We had to make this official. We got to make the rankings official, and so far it looks like it's nothing but nerds here in chat.
All right. right, I'm gonna ask chat. Chat, is this worse than Mr. Bean? Actually, no. Is this worse than Bubsy 3D? I think yes. But chat, do you think this is worse than Bubsy 3D?
I'd say it's worse than Bubsy 3D. I'd say easily.
I agree. Is it worse than Portal Runner?
Oh, look at this fantastical water level we didn't get to see.
Wow, it's so perfect. Worse, yes? Okay. I agree. Okay. We're near the bottom here.
Okay, so the bottom are games that make me depressed to think about. Let's keep going until I find a game that doesn't make me depressed.
Prince of Persia, Arabian Nights.
That's kind of in the middle. Let's see. Incredible Hulk, that makes me depressed. Blues Brothers 2000 definitely makes me depressed. Mm-hmm. Swagman makes me really depressed.
Ninja Bread Man? I think it's worse than Ninja Bread Man. I think it's between Ninja Bread Man and Swagman.
It's either between Ninja Bread Man and Swagman or Ninja Bread Man and
Spot.
And Spot.
Chat?
Spot had a similar free-roaming kind of deal to the gameplay. Eventually it devolves into this haunted house level where you just explore forever and it's no fun. That kind of reminded me of Rascal. All
right. I'm seeing either below Ninja Bread or above Ninja Bread. But above Ninja Bread? Okay.
I'm going to say above Ninja Bread.
I'm going to put it there too. You know,
Ninja
what?
Bread has a cut and paste feel to it. It was literally a copy of other games that existed. Rascal is original. People purposefully made this and they made it like this. And they have to live with it for the rest of their lives. Rascal for the PS1. Published by Psygnosis, developed by Traveler's Tales. May God have mercy on our souls. Wow. It lives up to the hype. You want a shitty game that'll make you feel bad? Play Rascal. That's my official recommendation.
As much as I was bitching, I'm glad we played almost an hour of that because I think
we had to know.
We had to know.
We had to know. Another thing I have to know. Is the Fifth Element as bad as people say? Let's play the Fifth Element.
Do people say the Fifth Element is bad?
It has a very terrible reputation. Almost as bad as Rascals, in fact.
Oh, good, good. I love when the reputation is bad.
This is a game made by Callisto, who back then was made popular because of their game Nightmare Creatures, which is a horrible game, but it came out at a good time for it to succeed. If that makes any sense at all. Then they went and got the Fifth Element license, and then they did this. And for whatever reason, even after this game completely failed at the market, and completely failed among people who enjoy good video games, they kept the license, and after this, for several years, they worked on a PS2 pseudo-sequel, and it did get released exclusively in Europe. It's called NYR, New York Racer. It's a racing game based in the Fifth Element universe. Only on the cover, it just says New York Racer. It doesn't say anything about Fifth Element.
What?
Yeah, isn't that weird? The studio who just completely botched this license that they took, just...
like,
they
no,
were so
no,
attached
no.
to it, they were like, no, we can do this, we can fix it.
The Fifth Element is gonna be a thing.
I didn't even know about New York Racer before I did the research.
You know, I've never seen the Fifth Element.
That's good.
I hear.
There's Leeloo.
I heard. She's Leeloo.
It's got techno opera. It's got Gary Oldman. What more do you need?
I mean, not much.
The opera singer is a playable character in the New York Racer, by the way. Forgive me for talking about a game we're not going to play, but you're going to see why in a second. Here you go, Alex.
Cool.
The Fifth Element. What do you think the Fifth Element is? I think it's love.
That's so much better than what I was going to say.
What were you going to say?
Poop.
It's not poop.
Thank
Why would it be poop?
Thank you, Taizo, for agreeing with me. Make it easy.
Make it easy. Might as well.
I'm in hell. Make it easy.
Fifth Element is poop. Earth, wind, fire, water, poop.
The Mundachiwan have in their possession the only weapon to defeat evil. Four elements.
A FMV.
Gathered around a fifth.
Probably taken direct from the movie. The ultimate. Can't post this archive on YouTube.
To protect life. Together they produce what the ancients called the light of creation,
yeah.
Able to bring life to the farthest reaches of the
universe. Yeah, almost the fifth element.
But if
he's showing off the anime art book he bought on eBay.
Then what?
Then light turns to dark. Life to death. Forever.
Come to think of it, I don't remember much about the movie. I just remember Bruce Willis having a lot of problems.
Isn't that like... Is there a Bruce Willis movie where he doesn't have a lot of problems?
That kind of sums up a lot of his movies. Oh, the cover for NYR does say inspired by the fifth element. I assume in tiny text.
Inspired.
It's just nuts to me that they released this game in, what, 97, 98? And then they just spent years on a PS2 spinoff. Only releasing it in Europe. Was that a frog?
I was gonna say, it looks like a cricket.
Do you think they sprung for Bruce Willis's likeness or voice in this? He plays a character called Corbin, who is kind of important. I don't think there's any getting around including him in this game. Ice V, thank you for the raid.
Thank you, Ice V.
What were you up to? Hope it went well. We're playing the fifth element for PS1. It's got Ruby Rod. So it's got that going for it. He's pretty well rendered here.
I like him. I like him. He's the gay. All I know about the movie is him. And
yeah.
That's because I'm gay.
He's good. He pops up in the movie like the second he's needed, and he just gives it a big old boost of energy.
That's what I heard.
But here he's silent. Unbelievable. Nope, he speaks. Good.
Corbin must get to the nuclear lab to find the cellular blue. Reconstruct Lilo using the DNA key.
Yeah, not a polygon wasted in this guy. Pinball game audio clips. Yeah, there's some stock noises I noticed, specifically with activating the computer. That one noise is in like every PS1 game. All right, New York racer, here we go. Oh, nope, you're not going to do any racing.
I got so excited that I was going to
race.
You're
not going to do any racing. You're just a guy.
Okay. So, bad news. Doesn't use the analog.
Nope.
Okay, hold on. Let me... Okay, there we go. All right.
It's a foggy day in New York City. Ooh, you found a secret. By hopping backwards. Good thinking.
I want to see his face, but it won't let me.
Just back him up against the wall. If it's anything like Rascal, the game will freak out. Oh, maybe the game...
This game's a little better built.
This seems to have better camera control than Rascal.
A little bit easier to control. A little bit, not by much.
I would assume this is built at least partially on the Nightmare Creatures engine, considering they invested so much development time into it. There was also Nightmare Creatures 2. Nowadays, I don't think anyone remembers Nightmare Creatures. It was popular for like a week.
It was huge. Hey!
Good start. It was a game, huh? I love games that you can describe that as like, yep, that was a game I played. You got a little kick. You got a huge jump. Look at that. Didn't see Bruce jump like that in the movie.
Gimme.
What I'm sad at is that Hudson Hawk wasn't released during the PlayStation era.
Yeah, well, why would it be?
I mean, I just wanted to see it get a PS1 game based on it instead of that shitty Nintendo one.
I'm glad I'm not the only person who thought that Hudson Hawk as a franchise was robbed.
It was robbed.
Thank you. See, people?
It's called kitsch, people.
Stop it! Stop shooting me!
It's called kitsch, people. Stop shooting me! Wow, real good gun feedback in this. Does it use both speakers or something? I only have one earbud in.
Oh, God.
Hudson Mohawk PS1 game, don't tease me.
There he's dead.
If only that existed.
I wish I wasn't being shot. Oh no.
Oh, this looks fun.
No.
Here's your platforming. Is this better or worse than the horrible lava room in Rascal?
Better.
That's true. You could walk in a straight line. Yeah, this is not the only PS1 game to prominently feature Bruce Willis. There is, of course, Apocalypse, which was a game where you were supposed to have him as a helper character, but they decided to make him the starring character instead. I think you did the right thing.
I'm cool.
Aw, your ride.
What am I gonna do?
Uh-oh.
Ah! That scared the shit out. No! Oh god, turn around, dude. Slowly turn around.
Back up. Okay. Back it up.
We're good. My hands are so sweaty.
Hudson Soft making a Hudson Hawk game. I can only dream. Now this is platforming, baby. Bob on Battlefield ain't got shit on this. Remember when we played Mario 64? That was good. Can you jump? Oh.
Whee! Oh, come on!
Was that damage you couldn't avoid?
Yeah!
That's cool. And then there's immediately a guy shooting at you.
Sometimes the audio and the sound don't work at the same time.
I've noticed that. This looks less technically competent, but more playable than Rascal, at least.
It's way more playable,
yeah. As an early impression. Dude, your life bar drains so fast.
Try me!
Alex desperately yelling, "Try me," at a room full of guys with machine guns he can't see, shooting him from off screen.
Are you dead now? God!
Nope, there's more dudes. That should be a pretty basic thing to, like, make dudes you can't see not shoot you.
Come on!
But then again, I'm not Nightmare Creatures developer Callisto.
Yeah, you're not Callisto. Don't backseat Callisto.
Okay, you guys did great. Good job making the video game.
Okay.
There's always a switch. Have you tried looking near the bunk beds? Everything explodes.
Okay, we are looking for a switch or a thingy. That's where we came. Okay, now we know where we came.
All right, Taizo, enjoy your sleep.
Good night, Taizo. Oh my god, I found another one! Oh, I'm so sorry for that.
Alex found another one.
Yeah, sorry. You? Is it you? Who's you? I'll kill you!
In Minecraft.
In Minecraft, never again.
Maybe it was just a ghost.
I'm hearing things. This sucks. Okay, jump.
Can you jump up there?
Yeah, I'm gonna try.
I think this would have been better served just being a 3D action game focusing on gunplay instead of having to be a platformer. Oh, I see. Yeah, shoot that. If you can.
Yeah.
Yes, this was originally titled Fury of the Furries. They had to swap in Bruce Willis at the last minute. This is the most I've ever seen of this game.
Stop it!
And so far, it's... I think we would have been a lot harsher on this game if we hadn't played Rascal immediately beforehand.
Absolutely. I don't like the design on that door.
Gives me a new appreciation for this. Are there furries in the Fifth Element? There's that one opera lady who is... She's like an alien, which isn't a furry.
No. I mean, there's...
The Fifth Element is furry. Nice. Do you think they juiced this game up with explosions to make it seem more exciting?
Yes. Okay. Oh, God!
That's true. That's true that Ruby Rod does wear the leopard print, therefore making it part furry.
Yeah. No, they're a gay furry.
You haven't even seen the movie, and already you're declaring characters to be gay furries.
Yeah, no, I've seen, listen, they're the only character I know from the movies. And so, yeah, of course I would know them, you know?
Yeah.
You don't have them. Go away. Go away. Go away. Go away. Thank you.
The fifth Uwu-ment. Cool. What happened?
I spawned on top of him, and then I kept pushing him back, and he was like, rah, rah, rah.
I heard that, yeah. He was making the Doom Guy noise. It looks like that's a spawning point for new enemies.
Yeah, so it looks like what I need to do is... That's the same thing.
Yeah, maybe that way. I like these identical corridors. What about that little thing?
Yeah, I'm gonna kick
See if he knows anything. Take him hostage. Well, he makes good cover.
Well, that's it. That's all I can use him for.
That's my favorite character so far.
I'm stuck.
Yeah, Wally. Can I take over?
Please, please, please take
over. Alright, good work, Alex.
No, I mean yes.
Alright, what do we got here? X is shoot. Square is kick. Triangle is jump? Really?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they love you.
This reminds me a lot of Largo Winch.
Yeah, I'm getting real Largo Winch vibes from this. Guy who's only played Largo Winch.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you want to open up? Hey, buddy. It's a cool walk you got going on there. You gonna open up? I guess he can't open up now. Should have thought about that. Is there a map in this? C game controls. All right. Jump left, jump right. Move slowly. Shoot slash kick. Circle is action. All right, that's what I needed to know. All right, this door is unopenable.
That door sucks.
It's a fake door. Bassist on this track was like, really? You just want me to play one note?
I'm like, okay. It's like, I'm getting paid either way, so, you know.
Yeah, cool. Other notes cost extra.
Yeah, I don't know why that door doesn't open. Any of these doors open? Come on, let Brucey in. He's nice.
Hey, come on, it's me, Brucey. I'm here to sing some of my famous blues songs you all love so much. Yeah, there's something we gotta do in here.
That sucks. Bruce Willis, he's the cool guy. It's Bruce Willis, he is the cool guy. Listen. Brucey is a cat's name.
Can he jump in? Oh, look at this! That's kinda cool. It would be cooler if I could figure out how to get past. If I could figure out how to get past these.
Yeah. So
we had Rascal experts in chat. Do we have any Fifth Element experts?
Anybody know what to do? Anybody want to backseat us? Can you jump on that thing? Like jump on its head? I don't know why I think jumping on its head would do something.
Boing. Boing.
No. You should be able to.
Hmm. I can jump to the left. I can jump to the right. I can cross my arms for some reason.
Can you push the robot? That's a good question.
Oh, yeah, good point. Brilliant.
Thank you. Thank you, Sir Gawain.
What the fuck?
Kill that guy. He sucks. Okay, thank you.
We have so many video game experts in chat. Nuclear yes! Lab.
Shout out to anyone who's good at this game. You got some shield.
I'm jumping. Does he have a thing where he can't back off of ledges? What if I did? Okay. Well, that's something.
Do you have to shoot this?
Pushing the use button all over the place.
All right, use it.
We go through here.
What about that yellow? Yeah, can you shoot that? The yellow glowy thingy? Oh, come on! It's a glowy thingy. You should be able to kill it.
There's another puzzle here, I'm sure of it. Oh, there was other bass notes.
Yeah,
did you hear that?
Yeah, did you hear that?
He went vroom, vroom. He did a flea maneuver. Maybe they got flea for this.
I think the bassist just got fucking bored. They're like, please, God. Like, let me.
Oh, that terminal was the one you could use.
That's
not the other ones.
Okay, it's fine. Whatever. Go through.
This is great. I love this. It's nothing like Rascal.
Yeah, I like this way more than Rascal.
Yeah, you could turn in place.
Yeah.
It's amazing. And you could walk forward and then stop and then turn. And it doesn't fuck you up.
Oh, you can go through the back way word. Okay.
All right, we unlock the other laser door.
Whee!
I love unlocking series of laser doors. It's my favorite video games.
You freaking love laser doors, honey.
Ever since Half-Life introduced Cinepax, what were they called again? Wait, this
set
did...
pieces.
Set pieces. Yeah, there you go.
Go back to the doors where you were at. Turn around.
There was another one.
That way, yeah. Go down that way.
Okay.
And then not there, but the other hallway. So you can go back to all those doors that used to be locked.
These look like they're open. I mean, yeah.
There
okay.
There you go.
Okay. Yeah, you know, Cinepax.
Can you shoot that thing?
Can I?
Hell yeah! Hell yeah! All hail Alex, King Gamer! King Gamer!
King Gamer.
King Gamer.
That's doing something. It's not telling me what, though.
Is this my... No, this isn't my game.
This game's kind of incredible. They tried to do way too much.
They did. I love it.
I think that's just turning on the coffee.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice.
Uh-huh.
Oh, you got the DNA key. Which you need to...
And I used the Nucleo Lab controller. Does this guy even look like Bruce Willis?
Not really. He looks like some blonde guy.
Oh, hey. He didn't seem too interested in fighting me.
Nah, he was.
He wasn't too interesting either.
No, not really. The objective is to go through the place where we... There you go! Transported away. Cool! Don't kill that. It's cool.
Whoa!
That's the nightmare creature.
He's got this move. Was this the game to introduce this move? The Max Payne? This is way before Max Payne.
Is David Bowie in Fifth Element? See, I don't know anything about the movie other than
That would be Omicron.
Okay. John Woo did it first, true.
Yeah, that's true enough. Oh shit! Get the fuck out! It's a jellyfish! Everybody evacuate! I freed the jellyfish! Is that bad?
It's fine.
Where did it go? Should I free these things too?
Yeah, free them all.
No alien testing.
We're against it.
Test on humans.
Test on me. I need the money.
Put me in your testing lab, coach. I think this would have been better served being more like a siphon filter than a, you know, a platformer.
Yeah, probably.
The jumping feels really unnecessary in this. Maybe they just felt like the game was lacking in some way. So it's got to be a platformer in addition to an action game.
Bruce-y alone. Right, my dick.
That was sick. Glad we have so many lives. Wait a minute. This game has vibration.
Yeah.
So shouldn't it have analog?
You'd think.
It does. I'm sorry, Alex. It still controls the same.
It's okay. I just was suffering for nothing.
It's exactly the same controls as the D-pad. Only, wait, hang on.
Is it worse?
It has Rascal syndrome when you use the analog stick.
Yeah, oh yeah, baby.
I'm just pushing right. I'm pushing left, I'm pushing right, he goes forward. Why was that a thing? Actually, you know what, put me back on digital controls. Turn it off. That's, you made it way worse, analog controls. Are we raging?
I'm raging. Yeah, I was diagnosed with Rascal syndrome.
It's a shame. You just can't stop walking forward.
I'm always bumping into walls and shit. It's very annoying.
This is where I freed the Metroid.
Yeah, turn, and that's where you went through the door. So maybe turn that way. Yeah,
okay.
See what's that way. Oh, and there's another door. So
I think maybe. I went in there.
Yeah, okay, try the other one.
I love that one bass note.
Me too.
Flea did a great job. Yeah, this is where that dude threw a grenade at me. Except there's another dude here, so maybe I didn't finish my job.
I like that hallway.
Hey, bro.
You should kill him.
No, he's a friend. Whoa, hey! All right. I tried to solve that peacefully.
Shoot it.
Yeehaw. Light him up. Wait, this is Lilu. Oh, okay.
You did it!
I beat level one.
You beat level one.
Oh, I think we can declare this one better than Rascal, at least. Because even though it had no map, it was easier to figure out and beat the first level. Let's see where this goes.
Okay. I do want to see the next level.
Beating the first level, not always a guarantee on Mascot Friday.
Cool Gatorade.
Yeah, she needed some electrolytes.
That makes sense.
They're building one of the famous Doozer Towers from Fraggle Rock.
Are you Fraggle Pilled today?
Yeah.
Cool skull.
Wait a minute. That's a Doozer skull.
Do we get it? I would be I would like to play as Lilo.
What about Stitch?
Thank you for censoring that for me, Gabe.
Well, thank God.
I didn't want it.
Finally, someone's considerate of the Mascot Friday stream.
I know! I'm so happy! I'm genuinely happy it was censored. Oh, thank you, game.
PCFX is like, no more boobs, please. Meanwhile, here in America, good old Puritan America. Puritan streamable America. Yeah, rest easy, Rolo. You're not seeing any boobs tonight.
Yeah, Yeah, I want to play as Lilo in a Lilo and Stitch game where I'm just running around Hawaii causing problems.
There was a
What the hell? Yeah. Yeah, I gotta play. I gotta watch this.
There was a Metal Slug game styled, a Metal Slug styled game starring Stitch.
Oh, that sounds good.
I think it was for GBA. You really ought to see this movie. It's fun.
She just jumped through the wall like it was Jiffy Pop.
Yeah. Lilo's a wild card.
Sure is.
Yeah, it is kind of like Alien Hominid, come to think of it.
Anyone
know
the movie.
What game I'm talking about? I'm pretty sure I didn't just make that up. Lilo, there's her multipass. Unbelievable! Let's do it. Mission 2, NYPD.
I like the screaming.
Good game for screams.
Mm-hmm.
And loud explosions. Stitch Experiment 626. That's the one.
You're Lilo.
Hey, look at that.
Whoa.
This is down. You just push down to do this.
Whee!
Man, once I stop, she's just going to throw up all over the place. What do we got? We don't have guns because we just got born. But we do have a kick. Whoop-ow! Yeah, attack high, please.
Please.
If you hold forward, she defaults to a low attack for some
boo.
Reason. Can I jump out? Whoa, 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 wow! Look at this animation! Oops! That's fine. Oh, man.
Hey.
Combat is not this game's strong suit. Oh, boy. Oh, let's just go. Let's just go. I'm opting out of the action sequences here. Can I just jump over? Let's find out. No.
No.
I'm just stuck. What do?
It says keep clear. Can you kick it? I was just assuming.
Good assumption. Good gamer instinct. I tried every other button except for the button that needed to be pushed. Funny joke game. See that? You can just kick through.
Cool.
They're puzzles in the sense that sometimes you have to push a button you didn't expect. That's what's puzzle-like about these puzzles. I'm just gonna run on through. Well, while I'm doing this, why don't you bring up the rankings?
Shall we rank?
Folks, based on what you've seen, is the fifth element better or worse than Gex 64? Will it be a Gex cool, or will it be a Gex nerd? Keep in mind, I am kicking a police officer in the back of the head. And this isn't depressing like Rascal was. It's just bad. Not to influence your vote, maybe you think this is good. Actually seen a couple of tail times, and it gets cool.
Mostly I'm seeing not low, but not too low.
Yeah, this is pretty bad, but in an expected way, an average way. Unlike Rascal, which went above and beyond in just being incredibly shitty in every possible way.
Better than Rascal, agree.
Yeah, I think at the very least, this is better than Rascal. But how much better is it?
Is it better than Futurama? I say yes.
Man, Futurama was pretty bad.
I say below Rough Trigger, above Futurama, but maybe it's too low there. Okay. Okay, chat agrees. Daniel, how do you feel about Fifth Element being between Rough Trigger and Futurama?
I kind of like that.
I like it too, shall we?
This game's bad, but it's functionally bad. You could tell that the people cared a little bit when they made this. It still sucks to play, but there are worse games. It's no Rough Trigger, that's for sure.
It certainly is not.
Wow, the Fifth Element and Rascal for PS1. We've played them both. We've been putting that shit off for years.
Yeah.
Now here we are, we've ranked them both. I remember this game getting like 3 out of 10 in EGN. Like, people really didn't like this shit.
It is better than...
I think in retrospect, this, maybe we can reappraise the Fifth Element. Maybe they were right to spend so many years working on the PS2 racing-themed sequel. Maybe. Maybe you were right after all, Callisto. But no one was ready to believe you. Tell you what I'm ready for, to not go through any more freaking laser doors. Oh, this time you push circle against the wall instead of X. Bullshit, get out of here with that. Be a real video game. Let's see what this poster says and then we'll move on. Hang on. See that right there?
Peace and law.
Peace and law, everybody. Peace and law.
Peace and law, I will no longer be answering DMs.
Thank you for all the fan mail. Peace and law, peace and law. I will no longer be responding to any of it. That's the Fifth Element for PS1. Surprisingly okay. It's a night full of surprises.
All right.
But will the third and possibly final game be the biggest surprise of all? This is Phix the Adventure. P-H-I-X.
I'm curious about Phix.
I think this was released as a budget game.
Yeah.
So you would only pay like $10 for this. This is also one of those games that came out in Japan a few years before the US version arrived. We'll see if we have time for Barbie. Maybe Phix will not interest us. I saw a friend of ours, Piro Rat, play this recently, and he went pretty well bonkers over it. I'll just leave it at that.
Yes, we know the people demand Barbie.
I'm sorry, Barbie. Sorry you had to fly all the way out to Austin, but we're just going to have to bump you. Phix, you know?
Being bumped for Phix sucks. Especially when you're fucking Barbie.
The Phix is in.
I like the font.
Phix in the magnetic world.
Okay, some people know what this is.
Some people have played this?
I see Rip Danny.
Uh-oh.
Oh no, this fucking game.
Oh boy, that's not a good sign.
Wow, what a beautiful day.
Oh,
sure, I'm glad
I love
I'm Phix.
This little creature. Oh, he's a freak.
He's a Furby. Yep,
people
life is
like
sure
him.
Great for me. Phix, the guy with the little lips that do that.
People hate Phix, by the way. Chad is freaking out.
You've seen enough. Nope, we got 12 more hours of Phix coming right up.
Yeah, he looks like he's from like a direct-to-video movie from a really weird Christian cult.
Yeah, some kind of religion's going on here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good. He has the power to absorb trash.
I want that power.
There it goes. Wow, he's covered in filth.
Phix. I'm Cleric from the Magnetica world. You just swallow something called the Magicka Stone. It is the most important object in our world.
Way to swallow it, idiot.
Listen, you are in big trouble. Don't swallow magnets. It's extremely bad for you.
Would you come over to the temple? And I can remove it from your body using my methods. Okay. Nope, don't need it. We're out of here. Good. Alex, good news. This does use analog controls, so have fun.
Okay. He looks like shit, but what do I know?
No. He's the next mascot star.
This seems like a Japanese budget game brought to the U.S.
Yep, this came out in 2003, so after the PS2, right around the time when the PS1 started to really suffer from super cheapo games. Blombie jams. It's a beautiful day at Faraday Field. We're about to play some Phix, mascot star of shit. Is he broken?
Yeah, he's fine.
All right, fuck this. Next game. Oh, man. This is an Alex game. This is totally the kind of game Alex would get into. Yep, it's a floating runner. This sure does remind me of Floating Runner. Yeah, Bubsy 3D2 looking good. Instant death. That critter is not waterproof. Do not put Phix in water. People are screaming for Barbie. You're already about to game over. That guy has an N over his head. I assume this game has some kind of polarity mechanic.
Yeah.
Right now you're neutral, given the letter N at the bottom. But you still can't walk into dudes even while you're charging. I was also thinking of Super Magnet Neo. That's another bad game. Didn't so much like that one.
Okay, see, I usually get repelled, but if I do that, I can go through.
Hmm, okay. That's something.
It pushed me into the water.
All right. Continue number one. This is now a 2cc. Oh, that would be cool if he rolled around and collected trash like a Katamari.
That's what I was hoping for, but...
No, he's just a shitty little guy. He's a shitty little guy who controls worse when there's things around that make him jump in the water. You having fun out there?
Die, die, die.
I wonder what does the S stand for?
N stands for north, S stands for south, the two polarities of magnetism.
I see, okay, there you go.
Well, technically it's negative and positive, but I guess north and south would also work, what I'm assuming.
The S stands for sucks. That could also be true. I think we may have met our match with this game. This may be the game that defeats the Retro Pals. Phix. You can jump over things.
Okay. There's platforming. I figured out how to change it to an S. It's
okay.
R.
All right, here we go. 100% playthrough coming right up. Yeah, this is a mascot plat drowner. Why does it sound like a baby?
What? You don't like the sound of a baby crying?
No.
Do you like the sound of a baby laughing? Because there's a song posted in the Discord you should listen to.
I'm not going to listen to that.
You should.
That's life. Well, the question is, are we going to be able to beat level 1 of this children's video game? Again, not always guaranteed. I was just thinking Jumping Flash. It's something about the mix of the audio and visuals.
Yeah.
Of course, it's nowhere near as good as Jumping Flash. Well, maybe it is. Maybe it's even better. What the fuck is this, Alex?
You get to play next. You get to decide.
Oh, man. Good God.
This is a video game for the... This is a video game. Out of all the video games, this certainly is one.
That's debatable. It looks and sounds like a video game, but I don't see you getting to level 2.
I will get to level 2. You can't stop me, I'm a beautiful bastard.
You're a Furby reject. Get over it. That's the new Danny, I'm telling it like it is all the time. Just instantly, whatever's on my mind, even if it's rude.
Well, you're the one who was demanding Phix. You were like, the Phix is in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm cool but rude. Like the turtle. See, it does sound like a baby, doesn't it?
Yeah, I don't like his baby voice.
This game has some real creepypasta elements. When Pyro was playing it on the title screen, eventually the music stopped looping and started playing like just like pre-recorded voices from like an office conversation, like in Japanese.
That rules.
I couldn't get that to happen when I loaded it up. I think it was just his copy. Yeah, maybe it was just like a later audio track that started playing incorrectly, but at the title screen the music just like stopped and then it started playing some people having a conversation. I swear this happened.
I believe you.
Alright, Alex has now mastered the polarity mechanics.
Okay, I'm good.
And he is ready to beat level 1 of Phix. Could have been a messed up cue sheet. I thought it was for sure an original copy, though.
For the raid.
Welcome, everybody. We're playing Phix.
Turn.
Phix the Adventure for PS1. Everyone's favorite platformer.
Phix.
Don't save.
I like how he screamed.
He screamed. Oh, man. Let's start on over. Let's do the training mode. Never mind. There's multiple training mode levels.
Don't do training mode.
We're going to do story mode.
Have fun. Oh, are other levels even worse? Fantastic. Beautiful. Glorious. I love video games.
I don't see how that's possible.
Phix.
All right, so the square button does this.
Yeah.
Triangle does this. It switches you between N and S.
Mm-hmm.
Circle does this.
Mm-hmm. That's your weapon. You get the... Oh, there is a map. Okay.
Hey, how about that? You can turn the camera a little bit. All right, I'm ready.
If you just ignore everybody, I'm gonna be so... I'm not mad.
Oh, I see. You gotta engage your polarity to things that suck you in.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. I thought I found the formula, but I guess not. This is a strange mechanic. These things that attract or repel you, but like I can understand it being polarity and all, but it just comes across as feeling like bad. It's bad game feel instead of good.
Yeah, it's you're making the game bad instead of good. Don't do that. That's one of the first things they teach you in gamer school.
Yeah, replace the bad parts of your game with good parts.
It's just logic, folks.
The logical gamer. You're welcome.
Okay, you're doing good. You're still alive. Don't go that way. That way is death. I know that.
All right.
I have fallen in that river so many times.
Nos.
Oh god, they're killing you.
Opt out.
I was gonna say they're injecting you with Nos.
Can you jump when you're magnetized?
Yes
you can. Okay. The controls are so strange.
They are.
God! I thought you were just playing it wrong.
Yeah, no. I am not just the clown man, but a gamer as well.
You say that like gamers can't be clowns.
I mean, that's not fair. There probably are gamer clowns.
I see. When you're the wrong polarity, the pieces run away from you. Did you notice that?
I didn't. That's funny. Nice! You did it! I couldn't beat that jump.
That's a hard jump.
You're at the end of the level! Go,
hey.
go!
Look at this!
Danny did it! Danny beat a level of Phix!
It can be done. The Phix is in. Have we said that yet?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I think you already did, too. I think we all did.
What does level 2 of Phix look like? This could be a first-time showcase anywhere on the internet.
Beautiful! Unique, varied environment. Gorgeous.
Yeah. It's all of those things. This is kind of not engaging. I think that's the right choice, actually.
It's working! It's working really well for you. Coin.
Oh, is that a coin? Look, they're running away! It's the most fucked thing I've ever seen. What if the coins ran away in Mario?
That'd be great, honestly. They should.
Things are tough out there for little old Phix. Oh boy.
What are you doing?
I don't know.
Okay, it's cool. Yeah, can you shoot those logs?
Swap like
polarity in the nodes to do a super jump.
There you go.
Thank you, Shining Era. Thank you. Thank you, Smubble. Thank you, everyone who suggested that.
I was about to figure that out. I figured it was something with polarity.
You're doing good.
Thank you.
For Phix.
See, and you said not to bump Barbie. I sent her ass back to New York.
There's a 37.58 any percent speed run of this game.
Wow, someone actually beat this.
It could be you. Or you, chat. you want to be a Phix speedrunner? Is this what's going to get you to the big time? Is this what's going to make you a Ninja Blevins? Or I don't even know who's popular.
Ninja
now.
Blevins?
I don't know. Who's popular?
Fuck.
Dreamworld.com? I don't know.
This is so bizarre. Why did this get made? Why did they release this over here? Well...
money.
Yeah. It was late in the life of the PS1, you could release anything. Sony would barely pay attention to whatever you put on that disc. Here? Not there.
You didn't jump!
I pushed the button!
I didn't see you jump, I just like...
I pushed the damn button.
Oh, sure. No, I'm kidding. Yeah, all the kids are into Phix now. They've moved away from Minecraft,
yeah.
And now they're like, I'll kill you in Phix.
Mm-hmm. They decided the Nerf guns that they make nowadays were too violent, so they're moving back to Phix.
See, you just gotta do a little jump.
The platforming in this is bad. It's bad.
I like the way your body is lifeless.
I like it too.
Yeah, Phix for Fortnite.
The polarity mechanic does not work like they thought it would. It does not make the game any kind of fun. You just get attracted to things unless you're the right polarity, or you get unattracted to them. And in either case, you're gonna take a death because you don't know how to deal with the controls.
Yeah, how do we get popular on Phix Talk or whatever?
Phix Talk. The game facts board for Phix.
God. That anime girl just killed your ass. I will never do a face reveal. I reveal my face, y'all will melt. I actually look like Phix, that's the problem.
Yeah. Ha!
She killed that anime babe! I'm sorry, but the bare naked ladies are gonna have words with you.
That's way too far! You can't make that. I'm gonna beat this level.
You die!
Alex? While I beat this level, why don't you bring up the rankings?
All right, folks.
Based on what little you've seen tonight, would you say Phix is better or worse than Gex 64? Let's make it official. Sorry to give Phix the short shrift, but the Barbie lobby has let me know their opinions, and we gotta play some Barbie tonight. That doesn't mean Phix can't get a fair trial. Look at him, he's jumping, he's hopping and jumping, doing all the things a little Phix can. Fuck him, fuck Phix, fuck this little guy, hate him, bottom of the list.
Better or worse than Mort the Chicken?
Put him in jail with the Blues Brothers in Blues Brothers 2000. Alright, don't let my opinions count, let justice prevail. Go on, justice, prevail.
Worse than Mort? Probably worse than Croc. How about, once again, how is this compared to the Fifth Element? Better or worse than the Fifth Element?
I had a much better time with Fifth Element.
Alright, worse than Fifth Element. How about compared to Rascals? Is this better or worse than Rascals?
I think this is better than Rascals.
Better than Rascals. Okay, so between the Fifth Element and Rascals. So let's go to Bubsy 3D. Folks, is this game better or worse than Bubsy 3D?
Now that's a conversation.
Slightly better? Okay.
It's hard
better
to say.
Than Bubsy 3D?
What did you even fall off of, you fuck?
There was a magnet polarity thing that pushed you. Worse than Bubsy, better than Bean. Worse because it doesn't have Bubsy. So between Mr. Bean and the Grinch lies Phix.
That makes sense to me.
Between Floating Runner and Rugrats. I
Floating Runner suddenly not looking so bad compared to Phix. I'm starting to see the hidden qualities of hidden Floating
Chad
Runner.
Chad is having some crisis over this.
I'm having a crisis just trying to play this. I can't believe this is real.
All right. Okay, folks. Final offer. Above the Grinch. Below the Grinch.
I'm so scared. I've never made it this far in the level. I'm afraid that some polarity thing is going to push me off.
Multiple people saying above, so except for one Grinch stand. So I'm going to put it above Mr. Bean, below Rugrats Royal Ransom. Wise Phix.
May he lie there forever. I beat level 3. It's so basic and yet so hard to play. And even when you do know what to do or how to play it, it's not satisfying. It just makes you feel bad. I want games that make me feel good. I want a feel-good game of the summer.
Boss stage.
Oh my god. Good. Put him in jail where he belongs. Mm-hmm. Oh, fuck!
I like it.
That's terrible looking. Wow.
Good luck.
All right, let's do this.
No, that's it. We're done. No way. That is...
Our final game of the evening is Barbie Explorer from PS1.
Phix.
He died. Well, Barbie, you got the whole world in front of you.
Everyone's been demanding your appearance.
Everyone else at the PS1 talent show just came out on stage and threw up. No one was impressed. All you have to do is go out on stage, do your thing, and not throw up all over the judges. Can you do that for us, Barbie? Can you do that? Rascal puked his guts out. Phix just exploded into meat. It's the worst thing I've ever seen in my life. This is the worst PS1 talent show ever.
Okay.
Might as well throw another game on the Barbie. The color Barbie pink is trademark.
It's true.
What happens if you use it without permission?
Mattel kills you. And right. Not in Minecraft.
Wow.
Yeah, Supreme Court decision gave corporations the right, the license to kill if they apply for it.
Well, that's fair.
I mean, it makes sense. All right. RuneCraft, RuneScape. That's the game.
I love RuneScape.
Barbie, that's rude as hell.
Cool, free jewel. Not even Barbie could resist the allure of Tomb Raider money.
That was gonna say Tomb Barbie. I'm fine, don't worry about it.
Then what happened, Professor?
Well, unfortunately, I was only able to find one piece of the Mystic Mirror. The other pieces have yet to be found.
This will make an incredible story for the paper.
She's a journalist?
I guess so. Here's the real story.
Behind the mirror, I discovered an ancient treasure map to the secret locations of the missing pieces. I've been awaiting an explorer who's up to the challenge. For legend says that if all 5 pieces are returned to the places around the mirror, they will unlock its mysterious power.
I like to think this really loud music represents her tuning in and out.
She's like, treasure in the modern world.
Jewels, huh?
Count on me, Professor.
Wow,
as
jewels.
Today, I'm reporting as Barbie, world-class explorer.
Now she's an she has like too many jobs.
She just quit her job as a journalist.
She's like, shit, this seems more fun. I don't know. What else am I doing today? All right, Barbie.
VR training. Wait a second. Wait a minute. There's VR training missions in this? Oh man. Oh man. Reality training level. Oh, I think this also has analog controls. Push the Xbox button.
Oh. Hey, I have to say it. This doesn't control bad.
This looks great. To walk.
To get past this object.
Did Mario play this? This seems like a Maroonie kind of game.
This, press the circle button while you run.
I can't believe this has VR training missions. That's so cool. When do you get to fight,
Snake?
Ocelot.
Get across this pit. You'll need to do.
Do you think you can jump?
To climb up or down a cliff, just walk up to the cliff edge or face. You can then use the left stick to climb around on the cliff face.
Climbable VR blocks.
I love that. Okay. I'm climbing, I'm Barbie, I'm climbing.
It's true, she's very stick-like.
Yeah, a little more so than usual.
Not much meat on those bones.
Is blocking the path again.
Yeah.
This time it can be moved by pulling it.
But oh, she even does the Lara Croft animation. Object. Man, what a rip-off.
Hold the square button. Now push and hold the left stick back until the object has been pulled far enough away.
Got it. Okay.
Unbelievable that we ranked this before a single Tomb Raider game. I thought about the final game for tonight being Tomb Raider, but I don't wanna deal with that.
Yeah, we got plenty of other games.
Look at this. Does Tomb Raider have VR missions?
This no. Object is blocking the path. We can move it out of the way by pushing it.
Got it. Oh, cool, I can go past that part. Wonderful.
She's having trouble. There you go. Yeah, I'd much rather play this than Tomb Raider, based on what I've seen so far.
This ledge is too high to...
Oh, I should have,
Yeah, just clamber up onto it.
Oh!
VR ropes! Close. There you go.
The ground in front is dangerous and could collapse at any moment. You must walk to make sure you get safely across. If you run, the ground will collapse and throw you into the pit below.
Oh no, Barbie.
To walk, push the left stick.
Now you have to master the basics of CQC.
Fuck CQC. Yeah, you don't need to teach me about levers. I know levers.
Where's the part where she wears an alligator? Should I play Metal Gear? Everyone likes those games.
Have you never played them?
I've beaten one and
Yay,
two.
Way to go.
I've beaten
you
two.
The VR
and
training
one.
Course.
And that's it.
Press the X.
I thought they were both pretty good.
Here we go. All right, it's time for Barbie.
Well, that's my controversial gamer opinions. I beat the first two Metal Gear Solids, and they were pretty good. Everyone says 3 is the best one, but it starts so slow.
Come on, Garrett. Let me do it, or else, Barbie, you're not an ally. You're gonna get in trouble if you won't let me be a Garrett.
Good news, Alex. Barbie is an ally.
Barbie's an ally, good.
Okay.
Barbie is goaded. Because she supports gay rats.
Use the left and right to bet.
Egypt.
Africa. Tibet. Africa. Let's go to Africa.
Let's go to Africa.
Alright.
We're heading out into
just drop me out of the airplane. Anywhere will do.
Time to steal a sapphire shield. That sounds
Central Africa. Okay, that narrows it down a little bit.
At least
okay. Here
Barbie.
I'm ready for this. I'm ready for this to be the best game we've played tonight. I honestly have no idea what to expect.
It has that Hanna-Barbera sound effect, so I'm happy.
Yeah? It looks like a shittier Crash Bandicoot, so I'm happy. Man, this is one of those on-rails 3D platformers. These are so rare, outside of Crash Bandicoot himself. I think the only other one of that type we've seen so far is Sabrina the Teenage Witch.
Yeah!
As well as, I think, the Scooby-Doo and the Cyber Chase game.
I was gonna say Cyber Chase, Scooby-Doo. How do I remember that? I can barely remember birthdays, but I can remember the mechanics of Scooby-Doo and the Cyber Chase.
Aha, I'm teaching you how to be a gamer.
Oh.
Forget your loved one's birthdays. Remember Scooby-Doo and the Cyber Chase.
It's fine.
It's Barb Bandicoot. Crash Barbicoot. Pretend I didn't say that.
Yeah, Mr. Bean was also one.
Oh yeah, Mr. Bean was a straightforward 3D platformer.
Forget Mr. Bean.
Hey,
almost forgot Mr. Bean.
An elephant.
I got trampled.
Ow! Not good, guys.
Look at this. The camera's behind your character.
Yeah, the
you can
camera's
tell,
actually really good in this.
You can tell what the objective is. There's no wandering around getting lost. Uh-oh, there's two paths up ahead. I hope we don't get lost.
That's fine.
A generous life meter? It's almost like this game is made for kids.
Yeah, I'm enjoying this, but again, game for children.
I tell you what, I'd much rather give a kid this than Phix.
Why? I died. Okay.
Well done.
Thank you.
Yeah, and we didn't want to play this. What were we thinking? We almost bumped Barbie. Barbie, come back. We're sorry we bumped you for Phix. That was the worst decision of my life.
Standing outside of Barbie's house with a boombox.
It's playing Barbie Girl. She's like, oh, I hate that fucking song.
She probably does. Oh my god, could you imagine? Oh, Christ.
You think you can reduce my life and my plight into the form of a Europop song? Fuck off, is what she would say. Just a Barbie girl in a Barbie world. You don't fucking know. You don't know shit.
I like your Barbie, by the way.
this Barbie's from New Jersey.
Okay, please understand. I love New Jersey Barbie. Okay, I'm good.
Yeah, you saw how I took that trampling? I've seen worse. I've seen Rush Hour on the I-80.
I don't know what it is.
I don't know either.
Sorry. We're in Texas. We just got the 35 or whatever.
I assume y'all's interstates have bigger numbers.
Monkey bars overhead.
Monkey bars, do it.
How do I...
New Jersey Barbie does just go by Barb, yeah. Hey, Barb. Oh, is there actually an I-80? I was just guessing. Alex? Alex! Okay, I thought you broke Barbie. I'm gonna have some explaining to do to Mattel.
No, she's fine.
She's stuck on the New Jersey Turnpike.
I don't know, I could... Oh. Dang, that was a pit. I could see her living next to Tony Soprano.
Mm-hmm.
They need to, you know, if Barbie has all these jobs, everything's so funny.
That chip slapped the shit out of you.
If Barbie has all these jobs, they need a mob boss Barbie.
I agree.
There are some monkey bars overhead.
Yeah, this is the best pitfall game I ever seen. Though we haven't played that Wii-era pitfall game where Pitfall Harry turns into a ball of flesh and tumbles down hills. So think of that when we rank this. Think about Ball of Flesh, Pitfall Harry. No one's thinking about that. They're too busy thinking of New Jersey.
They're thinking of branching paths. Cool.
Godfather Barbie.
I'd love it! Come on! Come on! Barbie with the horse head? You... what the hell? It's just a... it's a dead end. You can't...
DMV worker Barbie. David Cronenberg's Pitfall. All kinds of good ideas going on in chat tonight.
Yeah, chat. Y'all should...
put those ideas in a self-addressed stamped envelope. Mail it to yourself.
Hold on. Ugh. Okay, this way.
Speaking of idea theft, have y'all seen the new Pokemon VTuber? Or like the character in Pokemon who looks like a VTuber?
Yeah.
I was taken aback because she looks exactly like a VTuber I watch already. Like, exactly.
Yeah, no, I actually...
I was like, that's Dora 3.
What the fuck?
That's
what I thought, too! I was like...
She's got the big balls in her hair. She's got the big shirt that she just kind of swims in.
Yeah, no, it's Dora 3.
It's unbelievable. How could they get away with that?
Shout out Dora 3, because Dora 3 got ripped off. You can't be a funny maid, Pokemon!
No! That already exists.
Alright. Oh, I think I found the end.
Congratulations, you completed the level.
Alright, it's Danny's
Press
turn.
Press X button now
nice work.
To continue playing.
What do you think of this one?
I like it!
This seems okay. Yeah, go ahead and shout out Dora 3.
Yeah, no way!
She suffered enough.
Dora 3 is...
Really good streams there.
Yeah,
highly
like
recommended. Barbie Explorer. I'm finally getting to play it.
All right, enjoy.
What is this? What are these controls?
You mean they're normal?
Yeah.
Like a video game? Yeah.
When I turn around, you can see in front of her. It doesn't just shove the camera into the wall. The controls are predictable.
I regret to inform you that this is the best game of the night.
Oh my god. This is gonna... this is going to rend the Mascot Friday list asunder.
Mm-hmm.
What are we doing here?
You're just going down.
What is this?
Mudslide.
Not chocolate?
It's mud.
Oh.
Cool.
A lot of bugs in this Barbie game, though you can only hear them. Let's clip into it. Whoa! Rolling around at the speed of sound. She's really good at this.
I love this.
She's a perpetual motion machine. Alright, what if Barbie Explorer is sick? Are we prepared to deal with that possibility?
Okay, maybe to your right, jump to your right, see how there's a... No, I was just... I don't know what you're supposed to do here!
I don't know either. Is there monkey bars? No. Did the game just not load in the next part of the level?
Yeah, it looks like it didn't load properly. It was a glitch.
Yeah, maybe we need to kill off Barbie here.
Yeah, let's let her, Barbie has 15 lives, honey.
What?
See?
This doesn't even count as a hit. Let's quit the level and go back
in. Yeah, we went to the down arrow, but it didn't do anything. No idea. There was no way to climb down.
That's going
to
count against you, Barbie.
Native villain.
That's points off for sure.
All right.
That's going to be reflected in the IGN.com score. This is still better than God Hand.
Danny.
I know. It's an old joke at this point.
Okay.
Plus, nowadays we can all appreciate Imagine Party Babies.
Are we all imagining party? Ooh, there's something up there.
Aha. Aha. I'm imagining party babies right now.
It's fine. Okay. I have no idea how we climb down.
Well, we may have found the end of the game, but we found something more important. There has to be a trick here. What's the trick?
Can you push down to climb down?
Wait. Alex, you want to guess what button that was?
What?
R3. Except now it doesn't work. No, wait, it's L3. What the fuck? Well, at least we found out what it was.
Okay, game back to being good.
Yeah, it's still excellent, despite that one misstep. Yeah, you know, L3. I pushed every other button, none of them worked. Whoops.
It's fine.
These controls are buttery smooth.
I know, they're so good.
Do you get different hats in this game, do you think?
I hope so. Or is it just the one? They better give her outfits.
Maybe that's what you raid from the tombs.
Outfits?
Yeah.
Jewelry?
How do I have 17 lives?
You're good at this game.
All right, push L3 again. Ouch.
Fine.
Yeah, here we go.
There you go.
Here we go. We're climbing. Sorta.
There you go.
Getting there.
You did it. You got hiking boots!
Oh, fuck yeah!
It's fine.
Yeah, it lets you walk on the mud. I don't want to lose my hiking boots. Aw, man. Wait a minute.
It's just annoying now.
We can fix it. We can improve her. All new jumpin' Barbie.
She's got new jumps.
This game's amazing. This is the best thing I've ever played. Never mind that. Just the fact that you can roll downhill.
This is Barbie's Takeshi's Challenge.
Come to think of it, I don't know about the controls here. Let's see if we can do this. Nope, too far. Not far enough.
And you're stuck in geometry.
I fixed it.
Yes, it's very generous with lives.
Sure is. Alright, the platforming itself is a little bit awkward. But come on, it's Barbie. You can put up with awkward controls if it means being able to do this.
You love Barbie's combat rolls so much.
I love it. It's just so perfectly looped. There's no pause in it either. I don't know what I think about the lack of background music. It does put you in the setting, but I was kind of hoping we would have some, you know, Super Mario Brothers style music.
Fuck. Sorry.
Well, it's good we got to the actual platforming. It's because we can determine that it is, in fact, kind of awkward. But it's also very forgiving. Gives you a shit ton of lives. Mm-hmm. It realizes it's for children and it isn't just an impossible torture game.
Like Rascal?
Yeah, or Phix. In some ways, I liked Phix less than Rascal.
Same.
Fuck!
Is it ranking time?
While I climb this obstacle, why don't we rank Barbie Explorer? And while you rank, remember this, please. Please remember the good times with Barbie as she endlessly rolls into a wall.
Folks.
Barbie Explorer for PS1, is that better or worse than Gex 64, do you think? Is that going to be an RP Gex cool or an RP Gex nerd?
All right, we got
There's good and bad
cools,
things.
Couple nerds. Cools, nerds.
Maybe not the best game. It does have VR training. It does have the infinite roll. It does have a really lanky Barbie who feels slightly outsized for these environments. She feels really big.
Below, but only by a little bit. Okay, I can see that. How about I saw chat say below Toy Story 2 and above Sonic the Hedgehog 2006. I like that.
I like that,
I
too.
I actually like that.
We prepared to deal with that?
Chat, above Sonic 2006, below Toy Story 2.
You ready to live with the ramifications of ranking Barbie Explorer like that? Because I think you're right on the money.
Okay, that sounds good. Okay, okay.
All right, there we go. They said it couldn't be done. 4 3D platformers ranked in one night, and yet we've done it. Once again, we've achieved the impossible, thanks to everyone's help. Now Barbie can keep on exploring. Is this a better 3D Pitfall than any Pitfall actually was? I mean, I haven't played the PS2 and Wii Pitfall, but this is better than Pitfall 3D. I can tell you that much. But we've done our objective here. We've ranked the games.
We have.
And the stream has ended, and you know what that means.
I have no idea what it means.
It means that it's now the weekend. Please enjoy your weekend. Please spend your weekend as far away from Phix and Rascal as humanly possible. That's my recommendation to you. Otherwise, go play some Barbie. Go play some Fifth Element? You don't need to play that. Go play some good games. Go play
some games you like.
I like this one, though. I'm glad we got to spend some time with Barbie and her amazing rolling abilities.
You just love to make her roll.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to see what the game over screen is? You only have 3 lives left.
Really? Okay.
Yeah. C3, 2, just 2 more rolls. We're gonna see it. Gonna see the infamous Barbie death screen. Oh.
It's really infamous, Alex.
Very infamous.
Thanks, everybody, for watching. We'll be back next week with more streams. Patrons, you have a new poll up, and that'll determine what we play next Wednesday at 7 p.m. Central. Your choices are vampires or werewolves.
Ooh, ooh,
what's it gonna be? I have a feeling I know which one is gonna be picked, given the Retro Pals, what kind of people watch us. But vote with your heart, and we'll put together an excellent lineup for next week. That's my promise to you. Also, come back on Monday for part 2 of our PS1 Kusoge Showcase.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
That'll be a lot of fun. I'm going to look for Raid Target. Alex, wrap us up, would you?
We are on YouTube, youtube.com/RetroPals. We post full-length highlights there, including our latest one, which is a look at Brazilian Sega Master System games. So do check that out if you like Monica. If you don't like Monica, check it out anyway, because it's interesting. We're also on Twitter, twitter.com/RetroPalsHQ. We post when we go live there, when we've got new stuff up on YouTube, and all that good stuff. So do check us out on Twitter if you want to get all the Retro Pals news you can use, news you can't use, news for the blues, all that good stuff.
News of questionable worth. That's what we're all about. Man, Macaw is streaming Countdown Vampires right now.
Oh, hell yeah. Countdown Vampires.
That is a game
vampires.
That I've always wanted to get to, but could never really get into a stream. But that seems like the perfect Macaw game to me. Enjoy Countdown Vampires, the bootleg Resident Evil made by Bandai for PS1. Also, have a good weekend, and we'll see you later. Thanks for watching.
See ya, folks.